In Guatemala, a presidential election is likely headed for a runoff in August, as the early pace setter, former First Lady Sandra Torres, is expected to fall short of the 50% plus one vote needed for outright victory. As polling stations closed Sunday, international concerns were raised, such as allegations of corruption, the exclusion of a leading candidate, and the high cost of living. At the possible runoff in August, Torres will compete against diplomat Bernardo Arevalo, but Torres is expected to lose due to her lack of popularity in the capital. Stakes in the Guatemalan election are high, as poverty, corruption, and violence still envelop the Central American nation. Greece's New Democracy Party won Sunday's parliamentary election, with voters giving reformist Kyriakos Mitsotakis another four-year term as prime minister. With most votes counted, center-right New Democracy was leading with 40% of the votes and 158 seats in the 300-seat parliament. Mitsotakis thanked voters for their support as fireworks lit the sky. Mitsotakis, 55, a former banker and scion of a powerful political family, has promised to boost revenue from the vital tourist industry, create jobs, and increase wages to near the European Union average. The U.S. Coast Guard has also launched its own probe into the undersea implosion of the tourist submersible Titan. The Coast Guard's chief investigator says the finding of its Marine Board investigation will be shared with international groups to help improve the safety framework for submersible operations.
During the course of the NBI, the board will first and primarily work to determine the cause of this Marine casualty and the five associated deaths. The NBI, however, is also responsible for accountability aspects of the incident, and it can make recommendations to the proper authorities to pursue civil or criminal sanctions as necessary.
Over in Sweden, one person was killed and nine were hurt, including children, in a roller coaster accident at the Gröna Lund amusement park. Witnesses said the park's Jetline roller coaster partly derailed during a ride, sending people crashing to the ground. The victims are now being treated at a hospital and an investigation is underway. The 140-year-old park would be closed for at least a week to aid the police investigation. Spain grapples with a blistering summer heat wave with temperatures approaching 40 degrees Celsius. The nation's weather agency warns the hot weather will persist until Wednesday, June 28. This year's spring has been the hottest and second driest in Spain since records began in 1961. Spain earlier experienced a record-breaking heat wave in April, with temperatures nudging 40 degrees Celsius in some parts of the country. Spain's tennis star Carlos Alcaraz returned to the world number one after claiming the title in the Queen's Club Championships. He comfortably beat Australia's Alex de Minaur 6-4, 6-4. The 20-year-old athlete is the fourth Spanish player to win the pre-Wimbledon tournament. He now hopes to emulate Rafael Nadal, who also won the Queen's in 2008, before going on to win the Wimbledon for the first time. Aside from Nadal, several other players, such as Andy Murray and Pete Sampras, won the prestigious Wimbledon after conquering the Queen's Club.
I feel great, you know, to leave this trophy, to have my first tournament on grass. You know, it's amazing run for me this week. I played an amazing level at the end of the week. So see my name in a trophy means a lot. So I'm gonna keep that memory for the rest of my life for sure.